setup, Node.js, gulp, git and GitHub. Today we'll install these tools to help us develop quicker and be efficient about it. This setup is only needed once per computer. Unless you want to tweak something about it, you'll even forget it. So make sure to pay a visit back here in case you do so. With that said, let's get down to it. Hey, what's up guys? I'm Marian and my passion is to create the web and help you be part of it. If you're new over here, this is CodeUp. Well, you learn to code websites like a professional with or without any knowledge of coding. So consider subscribing. Our first step for today is to install Node.js. Node.js is the JavaScript engine that runs inside your Google Chrome browser. By installing it, we'll be able to run JavaScript on our system without the need to be inside the browser. Before we install it, let's find out how we can quickly check if we have it installed on our system already. To do that, I'll want to launch the console, which on Windows is the command prompt, or on Linux and Mac it's called the terminal. So to launch the console on Windows, I'll hold the start key and press R, and inside here I'll type CMD, shortcut for command, and hit enter. Over here I'll say node space dash v, and there are two possible outcomes. If we have node installed, we'll get the version of node. If we don't, the system will let us know that it knows nothing about this node command. So with that said, let's go and Google Node.js download. We'll follow the Node.js.org download link. And unless you have a specific requirement for a version of node, I recommend you to go and click the current and grab the latest and greatest version of Node.js, the one that's appropriate for your operating system. I'll choose the 64-bit version MSI installer for Windows. I'll download it and run the file once the download is finished. I'll hit a couple of times next until the install process is finished. I'll quickly close the command line so we can practice opening it again. Once the installer is finished, I'll hold the start key and press R. I'll type CMD and hit enter and say node space dash v. And we can see that node is installed and the version of it is 8.2.0. On Windows, the Node.js installer also installs for us the Node Package Manager, which we'll be using a lot in our future projects. So to check for the Node Package Manager version, let's type npm space dash v. And we can see that we have a 5.3.0 version installed. Our second step is to install gulp. Gulp will be responsible for watching files, running build processes, like compressing images, convert PUG to HTML, optimize content, refresh our browser automatically when changes occur, and many other features that we'll see in our next lessons. Now let's firstly check if we have gulp installed already or not. To do that, we'll type gulp space dash v, and we'll get gulp is not recognized as an internal or external command, which means we don't have it installed on our system. To install it, we'll ask our node package manager to install gulp globally, so it will be available for all our projects. So npm I for install space dash g for global, and the name of the package is gulp CLI hyphen CLI. This will grab gulp and install it on our computer. Once this is finished, we can check if gulp is installed on our computer again. Gulp space dash v. And we can see that the CLI version is 1.3.0, and this is the same as gulp version 4. Our third step is to install Git. Git is a version control system. It allows us to keep track of our changes and our files, just like steps.html did for us in Coding is for Everyone beginner series. With the exception that this is a professional tool that almost all developers use. This is just the tip of the iceberg, as Git has lots of other features to offer us, like code reviews, project management, code hosting, and so many more. Now let's check if we have Git installed on our system already. To do that, we just type git and we get that Windows does not recognize this. So to install Git, let's Google it. Download Git. We'll follow the Git SCM downloads link and get the appropriate version for your operating system. I'll choose the Windows one and save it in my downloads and run the file once it finishes downloading. I'll hit next a couple of times. And close the command prompt so we can practice opening it again. Once the installer is finished, let's open our command line again, hitting start and R key. I'll type cmd and hit enter and say git. This time we get a message with some help information how to use Git. That means we have Git installed on our computer. Our next step is to create a GitHub account. So let's visit github.com. I'll encourage you to sign up for GitHub and just follow the steps. Choose the free version, as for the moment it's not necessary to have a paid version. I already have a GitHub account created, so I will sign in. Once you're signing into your account, all you need to do is search for pug starter, P-U-G-S-T-A-R-T-E-R, pug starter. And we look a bit down where you see Marian's Berlia slash pug starter. Alternatively, you can type in after github.com slash marianzburlia slash pug dash starter. So Marian Zberlia slash pug dash starter. And I want you to click on this start button so you add this project to your favorites. So next time, instead of searching for it, you go into the top right corner and click your profile icon and choose from the menu your stars. And you can find here all your favorite projects, and among them it will be pug starter. Our last step would be to install a text editor like Visual Studio Code if you haven't already installed it, check out the description of this video below and you'll find out links towards how to install Visual Studio Code or Atom Text Editor. Other editors that I recommend are Sublime or WebStorm or any other text editor that you feel comfortable with. That is it for today, guys. I'm so excited. I'll be waiting for you in our next episode where we'll start to build properly a professional website. We'll start recreating our previous project. If you're new over here, I encourage you to subscribe because there will be more great content like this coming up. So I'll see you in the next lesson.